Hello everybody, hope everybody's doing great today. Appreciate the one of you two to be watching this video. I hope you enjoy it. And as you see in the background, we're getting ready for Christmas here for you future viewers who are wondering, you know, what time of year was he making this in? We got about a month before Christmas. And the great benefits of living in the Midwest or the Great Lakes region is it's cold out there today. It's very cold out there today. But I'm in this nice warm house. And I'm ready to talk about this show called In Love and in Deep Waters. By the way, don't tell my wife this, but if you hear some snoring, it's her. Of course, my wife does not snore. That's what I tell her. But she's right here next to me, sleeping a little bit. So if you hear her, it's not her, okay? She doesn't snore. Anyways, let's talk about this In Love and Deep Waters. This is a Japanese movie. It takes place on a cruise ship, and it's kind of like your murder mystery type of movie. It's about these two people who one of them works, the guy. He works for this cruise ship liner, and he's kind of like your butler. He shows you to your room, gets the stuff you need, you know, that kind of person. And he meets this other woman here who comes on to confront his girlfriend, who was supposed to meet him on this cruise, but unfortunately she didn't make it. And the reason she didn't make it is because she's cheated on him with this other passenger's boyfriend. And so it's basically a love romantic movie as well, romantic comedy movie as well, as these two are trying to solve a mystery. Which was kind of weird about this movie. It says, even though it is kind of your whodunit kind of movie, your mystery, your whodunit kind of show. You already know pretty much from the very beginning of the crime whodunit. However, they do kind of throw you some curveballs. They do give enough clues throughout the movie to show you who the true murderer is. So I did appreciate that. Like I said, I do like these kind of mystery type of movies, but I'm always the last one to discover who it is. You know, I'm the idiot of the room. But this one, I kind of figured it out to give me enough clues where I didn't know who did it by the end of the movie. But it still was kind of a surprise because I didn't think it was actually going to go there with this. So, like, if you like mysteries, this is a good one for you because it's really, like, even though you think you know who did it, who done it, gives you enough clues to really reveal who the true mastermind of the murderer was. Or the true criminal. He wasn't really a mastermind, but he is the one who did the final deed to kill this person. You get plenty of motives in there, so you get the whole elements that you need for a murder type of show. I would say this is supposed to be like a comedy, but it wasn't very funny. I mean, there was some comedic elements in it, but I found it was like more of maybe a dramedy a little bit. But you do get, but it is well written, but it's supposed to be advertised as a comedy. I don't remember myself laughing very much during the show at all. The two lead actors are very well. I did like the relationship between them. I thought they'd work very well together on screen. Their whole romance that they have is plausible. You can see that they do grow to like each other, to eventually love each other, that kind of stuff. So I do feel like it was well written, both for the mystery part and for the romance part of this show as well. I'm always amazed on how big they can build these cruise ships without them sinking. I mean, the cruise ship that they're on is huge, and I'm pretty sure it was probably, I don't think it's CGI. I'm pretty sure it looks like it was filmed on location. I could be wrong, but it looks like it was. You know, I'm not the smartest guy out there, you know, the sharpest tool in the shed, but I'm pretty sure like most of it was filmed on location. And I had to go on a cruise, I gotta say myself. That cruise ship looked very good. It looked like it'd be very fun to do. I'm always, you know, I got that Titanic fear that it would sink, you know. I'm pretty much traumatized by the Titanic. Why is it I'm going on cruise ships? Anyways, let's get back to the movie. But yeah, it was very well shot as well. Great photography. The characters are interesting. Your villains really do have a good motive for why they're wanting to do what they're doing. and why they trying to kill off this old man. You do get that kind of Weekend at Bernie's feel, I will say like that. Because once he's dead, you know, they're trying to get away with this murder. So they're trying to keep him looking like he's alive. So you get a little taste of like a Weekend at Bernie's element in this show. My final verdict is here, you know, very positive. We got highly recommend, and recommend with caution. I'm just going to give this a low recommend, you know, almost a recommend of caution. If you like murder mysteries, I believe like you would like it. If you like romance comedies, you like the romance part of this. Like I said, I didn't really find it very funny. The humor wasn't very heavy. I don't remember laughing at all during this. But there was some funny elements, you can say, to this. But it's more like, a light drama. We'll say it was a light drama. Really did feel for our two main leads, you know. You were kind of rooting for them to get together. You hated their counterparts and stuff. Of course, in any kind of romance stuff, you know, you get that part of the movie where they had to split up. So you get that a little bit there, but it's only like a 2-minute thing. But overall, yeah, I'll give this a recommend, a light recommend. If you like mysteries, I think you'll enjoy this one. It's a light mystery. Like I said, you know who did it from the beginning, but you don't really know who the true mastermind is. Who put the final nail in the coffin? That's kind of still up there in the air. Or the final, who finally did the deed to kill this guy. And it just got a pretty good romance story to it as well. I think you would enjoy it. So hope everybody has a great day. And I'll see you on the next, or you'll see me on the next video because I can't see you. Have a great day.